for watching these videos. In this video, I am explaining the circles MCET problems, and this is the video number 2. And the students who will follow these videos will definitely get very good marks in the coming MCET examination. So all of you watch the videos, make the notes, practice the sums, okay? And in the description, I am giving the link of the practice problems of the circles PDF. So all of you, after watching the video, once open the description and see the PDF and solve those questions also. Those are also very important problems. Okay, let us start the class. This is sum number 9. The question is, if 2x plus 5 is equal to 0 is the equation of the diameter of the circle which touches the lines 4x minus 3y plus 10 is equal to 0 and 4x minus 3y minus 30 is equal to 0, then what is the center and radius of the circle? Okay. What is the center and radius of the circle? We want the center and radius to this circle. What is given? The circle touches the lines. Observe that here the two lines are the parallel lines. The two lines are the parallel lines. That is, this is the first equation, 4x minus 3y plus 10 is equal to 0. And this is 4x minus 3y minus 30 is equal to 0. And 2x plus y is equal to 0 is the diameter of the circle. That is, the center lies on this line. Okay. The center lies on this line. And these two lines are the tangents, means the distance between these two lines is nothing but the 2r value. Understand? R plus r, 2r. That is, 2r is equal to the distance between these two lines. What is the formula for finding the distance between the parallel lines? Modulus of c1 minus c2 is square root of a square plus b square. That is, c1 is equal to 10 minus minus 30, 40 by square root of a square plus b square, 16 plus 9, a is equal to 4, b is equal to minus 3. That is 25. That is, 2r is equal to 40 by 5 is equal to 8. That is, the value of the r is equal to 4. Okay. Therefore, r is equal to 4. Radius is equal to 4. Now, once check the options. In the first and third options, we have that radius is equal to 4. That is, answer is either first option or third option. Now, how to check which of these two is the answer? Just also given one condition. What is that condition? Diameter is equal to 2x plus y is equal to 0. Okay. Now replace the first point in this line. Then what we get? Minus 4 plus 1, which is not equals to 3. Now replace the second point in this equation. Then what we get? 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. Yes, this is the correct answer. Third option is the correct answer. Third option satisfies third option. Here this point satisfies the diameter equation and radius is equal to 4. So this is the correct option. So answer is the third option. That's all. Next question, sum number 10. If the car joining the points 2, -1, 1, -2 subtends a right angle at the center of the circle, then center and radius will be. So given that the car joining these two points subtends a right angle at the center of the circle. Okay. Suppose this is the center of the circle. If the line joining these two points subtends a right angle, that is given that the angle between, suppose these two are A, B, that is given that the lines AC is perpendicular to BC. This is the given condition. Now, this is given, we have to find the center and radius. Okay. Okay, listen. Here also first I take the options. What is the first option? Here also first I take the options. What is the first option? 2, -2 and 2. And the second option, 2, -2 and radius is equal to 1. Okay, listen. So, first I take the first option and verifies the option here. So, what is C here? C is equal to 2, -2. Okay. Now, what is these two lines are perpendicular lines, means product of the slopes is equal to minus 1. Okay. Now, what is AC slope value? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. That is, minus 1 by 0. And what is BC slope value? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. That is 0 by 1. Of course, these two lines are the perpendicular lines here. So, these two lines are perpendicular lines. Now, what is the radius value? Checking the radius value, 2 minus 2 whole square, distance between these two, that is r is equals to square root of 2 minus 2, 0 plus minus 2 plus 1, minus 1 whole square, that is 0 plus 1, radius is equal to 1. So center is equal to 2 comma minus 2, r is equal to 1, means the second option is the correct answer. Here we have that radius is equal to 2 in the first option, but we get that radius is equal to 1, understand? Very easy question, just doing the verification. First we take that center is equal to 1 value and checking that whether the lines are perpendicular or not. So here the lines are perpendicular. Again checking that radius value, distance between point and center, that is equals to 1. Therefore that is the second option is the correct option. Also check the third and fourth options, but those options doesn't satisfy here. Okay, so this is the only option which satisfied. Therefore this is the correct answer. Answer is the second option. That's all. Next problem, sum number 11. If a circle with radius 2 units touches the x-axis at the point 1, 0, then its center may be. Okay, listen. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. What is given? The circle with radius is equal to 2 touches the x-axis at the point 1, 0. Suppose this is 1, 0. The circle touches the x-axis and also given that radius is equal to 2, then what is the center? That is, so we can draw two circles which satisfies the given condition. We can draw the circle like this also and we can draw the circle like this also. Here also we take that radius is equals to 2. Now clearly from the diagram, what are the centers? This is equals to 1, 2. Already we know that if the circle touches the x-axis, then r is equals to, we have the 1 means, here also we take that 1. And what is y coordinate? This is equal to 0 and radius is equal to 2. That is, this value is equal to plus 2. And what are the coordinates of this point? 1, -2. On the distance, this distance is equal to 1 and radius is equal to 2. So therefore, the possible centers are 1, ±2. Clearly from the diagram, we can say that center is equal to 1, 2. And center is equal to 1, -2. That's all. And that is the third option. Next question, sum number 12. The distance between two parallel chords each of length 10 units is 24 units. Then what is the radius of the circle? Okay, what is given here? This is the circle. These are the two parallel chords. The distance between the two parallel chords is equal to 24. That is, the distance between these two lines is equal to 24. Since this is the center, half of the value is equal to 12. Okay, total is equal to 24 and half and half is equal to 12, 12, and length of the chord is equal to 10. So total is equal to 10 means half is equal to 5. Okay, this half distance is equal to 5, this half distance is equal to 5, total is equal to 10. What is the radius of the circle? That is the given question. So see here, this is the right angle triangle. So what is r value here? From the diagram, r square is equal to 12 square plus 5 square. Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. The radius is always perpendicular to the chord. That is, this angle is equal to 90 degrees. That is, r square is equal to 169 and r is equal to 13. When we know the diagram, then directly we can tell the answer here. R is equal to 13. That's all. Next problem, sum number 13. The locus of the center of the circles which touch the line 6x minus 8y plus 5 is equal to 0 and 6x minus 8y plus 13 is equal to 0 is 6x minus 8y plus k is equal to 0, then what is the k value? Okay, this is the given question. What is given? We want the locus of the center of this circle. Suppose this is the center. Now we want the locus of the center of the circle. We want this line equation. Also given that which touches the lines. Given that the circle touches these two lines. Okay. Already from the diagram clearly these three lines are parallel to each other. Okay. Now what is this line equation? Very easy. The equation of this line is 6x minus 8y plus constant c1 plus c2 by 2. 5 plus 3 by 2. That is 18 by 2. that is equals to 9. Therefore, the answer is 6x minus 8y plus 9 is equal to 0. Okay, 18 by 2. Therefore, the value of k is equal to 9. That's all. And that is the last option. Okay, the locus of the center. These two lines are parallel. So, this is also the line parallel to each other. And this is the midline of these two. Therefore, the formula is ax plus by plus c1 plus c2 by 2. Just to take the average of the constants. That's all. Next question, sum number 14. The locus of the point of intersection of the lines x is equal to 1 minus t square by 1 plus t square and y is equal to 2t by 1 plus t square, where t is a parameter, is a circle whose radius is. Given that the locus of the point of intersection of these two lines is a circle, we want the radius of that circle. Okay, given that the locus of these two equations is a circle, that is, first of all we have to find the locus of this equation. That is, first I replace the t is equal to tan theta in the above equations. First I replace that x is equal to tan theta in the given equation. Then what is the first equation? 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. And the second equation is 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. Okay. Now what is 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta? This is nothing but cos 2 theta. And this is equals to sin 2 theta. I am taking that squaring and adding the two equations. That is, x square plus y square is equals to cos square 2 theta plus sin square 2 theta. But cos square theta plus sin square theta is equals to 1. Therefore, the locus of the given equations is x square plus y square is equal to 1. Clearly, this is the circle with center is equal to 0, 0 and radius is equal to 1. Okay. So, this is the circle with center is equal to 0, 0, radius is equal to 1. That is the second option. That's all. Radius is equal to 1 here. Next question, sum number 15. If the equation of the circle passing through the points 2, 1, 5, 5, minus 6, 7 is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0, then what is c value? So here we want the equation of the circle which passes through the three points. Okay, we have to find the c value. That is, we have to find the equation of the circle passing through these three points. So first listen here. First, I take that this is equals to A point, this is equal to B point, this is equal to C point. Next, finding the slopes values. Slopes of the lines AB, BC, CA. Okay, what is AB slope? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. AB slope is equal to 4 by 3 here. And what is BC slope? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1, 2 by minus 11. And what is CA slope? 7 minus 1. 6 by minus 8. Now slope of the AB is equal to 4 by 3 and slope of the CA is equal to minus 3 by 4. Means these two lines are perpendicular to each other. Okay. These two lines are perpendicular. What are the perpendicular lines here? AB and AC. AB and AC are perpendicular lines. Means this is the right angle triangle. What is A point here? 2 comma 1. What is B point here? 5 comma 5. And what is this? Minus 6 comma 7. Okay. So here AB and AC are perpendicular. That is, here we take the A point. Right angle triangle. What is the center of the circle? Suppose this is the circle that passes through the three points of the three vertices of a triangle. Okay. Now what is the center here? Center is nothing but the midpoint of these two. That is equals to minus 1 by 2 comma 12 by 2. That is equal to 6. Angle triangle. The center is nothing but the midpoint of these two vertices. Okay. That is, therefore, minus j comma minus f is equal to what we get here, minus 1 by 2 comma 6. That is, the value of j is equal to 1 by 2 and f is equal to minus 6. And already given that the circle passes through the three points, I take the first point here and replacing this point in this equation. Okay, that is 4 plus 1 plus 4g plus 2f plus c is equal to 0. And already here we have g comma f values, or replace those values. That is 5 plus 2 minus 12 plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, the value of c is equal to 5. Okay, 7 minus 12. C minus 5 is equal to 0 and c is equal to 5. That's all. And that is the last option. Very, very easy. First, we have to check whether the given lines form the right angle or not. The lines form a right angle, then it's very easy to find the c value. It's very easy to find the center of the circle first. Okay. Next question. What is the equation of the circle which passes through the points 1, 2 and 2, 1 and whose radius is equals to 1? Whose radius is unit is, that is radius is equal to 1. Okay. We want the equation of the circle which passes through the given points just to doing the verification. So this is the first option. Now replace the first point here. 1 plus 4 minus 4 minus 8 plus 7 equals to 0. Okay. And replacing the second point, 4 plus 1 minus 8 minus 4 plus 7, 12 minus 12 equal to 0. Yes, this is satisfied by the both points. And what is the radius to this one? G square, G is equal to 2, 4 plus F square, F is equal to 2, minus 7, 8 minus 7 is equal to 1. Yes, all conditions are satisfied by this equation. So this is the correct option. Also check the remaining options. All conditions are not satisfied there. This is the only option which satisfies all the conditions. Therefore, the answer is first option. That's all.